Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabbit here. And here we have the KS0 Ultra from Ice River. And overclocking firmware is now finally available from PB Farmer. I've been waiting for this firmware for quite some time, as most of you guys may be aware. So I'm going to update the firmware here and see what kind of hash rates we can get, what kind of power consumption we need. Now remember, when overclocking, you will need a bigger power supply. So you will need something like 160 to 180 watts. I got 180 watt power supply hooked up to this one, as well as external cooling. I also have the Noctua fan sitting on top. It's a USB powered fan, so it's nice and compact and plugs right into the KS0 Ultra all by itself. You can get like shroud kits and a whole bunch of stuff, but I feel that's a lot of extra money and you don't really need all that. But then again, I don't know yet until I try this out. So I'm just going with the one Noctua fan. This is all I use for KS0s and KS0 Pros, and it was more than enough. So let's see how well this firmware does do. This is only currently available for the KS0 Ultra. It will be coming out for all the KS5s, the Ls, the Ms, and so on. Later on, hopefully today, maybe tomorrow after this video releases, you'll probably already be released, but we don't know. It is coming very soon, and I can't wait for that one because then we can actually underclock some stuff, set our own voltages, and run a lot more efficient. The way the Casper hash rate is going, I do prefer efficiency over overclocking, but we are testing out overclocking in this video.
Oh, nice. Hey, guys, come here. Check this out. I'm getting some miners from Miner Bros. I bet you didn't know this. With Miner Bros, what you see is what you get. The cost of the item is shipping cost to your door, including import fees. That means no hidden fees later on, unlike the other guys, which nail you at the checkout. So what are you waiting for? Get your ASICs today. Link is in the description, and code RABID will grant $50 off every individual item.
All right, so coming into the GitHub right here, we can see 0.8.0 OC firmware for Ice River ASICs, and this is KS0 Ultra support has been added, KS5 support coming soon in a follow-up release. So this is where all the files, make sure you do download the proper one for your miner. Obviously, if you're running a KS0 or KS1 or 2 and stuff, you may already have this and know what to do. But remember, we're going to need KS0 Ultra. Do not install any of the other ones onto this. Another thing, hold the button down for 10 to 20 seconds. Reset it to factory defaults before uploading this firmware, which I already did. I'm just waiting to upload it at this point. And don't upload it directly over other third-party overclocking firmware that's currently available out there. So just reset everything to be safe. All right, so I did factory reset it. When I hit the refresh button, we can see the known machine is offline bug is in effect. Now, it'll be interesting to see if PB Farmer firmware fixes this, but we'll find out here. So now I'm just going to go into the firmware upgrade. We're going to select file here, and then we're just going to go into my downloads and then select the KS0 Ultra update. Open that up and then update this miner. Machine is not connected, so it looks like that's not even going to work. If you're doing this bug, or if you're still getting this bug, some people don't have this issue. I guess you're going to have to manually set your static IP and then connect to it, because right now we still have a pain in the arse Ice River ASIC. All right, so I edited that all up and now it reset it and we do have a dashboard. So back into firmware upgrade, select our file here, select our KS0 Ultra update, open it up and hit the update button here. Let it do its little loading process or dealio. Hurry up. It's taking a sweet arse time. Let's go. And then operation succeeded. So we're going to hit OK. Confirm restart. Yes, if it doesn't do a confirm restart, I know in the previous versions, KS0s and KS0 Pros, sometimes it doesn't ask for that. Make sure you do restart it before going forward, because it is going to have to load that firmware. All right, so after a little while here, it logged in and we can see software disclaimer just like the other versions, and we're just going to hit that accept button. So now we do have Ice River plus PB Farmer, so that's awesome. Let's put this in the dark mode because that's what we like. We don't like that light mode. Actually, it's a gray mode, a little bit better than the white. So we got to set everything up here, and by default it is running to PB Farmer's address and stuff, so you're obviously going to want to swap that over to your own address. All right, so I did add Casper pool here. Here's my address, the name of the worker, password of just an X here, and then hit that save button in the side. This is new compared to previous version I have used. Maybe it's in the last version for some of the other ones, but before, you just have to add pool. This will not work. Make sure you hit the save button or you'll be like, what the heck, what's going on here? So coming back into home, We can see that everything is working. Here it is. We're getting no accepted shares yet, but we can start to see our chip temps and everything that's going on. So now we're going to come into our miner. And this is where all the magic happens. I'm going to start with this. One thing I really like about this, I'm going to target a temperature, a chip temp here of about 70 degrees. That way it'll run the auto fans at that all on its own. So I'm going to have a minimum fan speed, I guess, of 60% here. So we're going to save that. Target a chip temp of 70. Remember, Ice River ASICs like to run warmer. If you cool them too much, they will actually underperform to where they should be. So keep that in mind. Now, this is where all the magic happens. You're going to want to set your overclocking stuff here manually. Jump up and clock offset small amounts at a time. Then when you start noticing that hash rate start to drop or, you know, it just collapses or something, that's when you need to start adding a bit more voltages. Then you add a bit more clock and then you add a bit more voltages. Kind of go back and forth till you get a nice middle ground depending on the power supply you have. Keep monitoring it. You don't want to use too much power. You don't want to be overheating this too much. So just work in small increments, clock first, then voltages, then more clock, then more voltages, and so on until you hit to wherever you want to be. So I'm going to play around with this and see what I can kind of get. All right, so we got some progress coming on here. I saw our normal dip, and then I lost all my hash rate when I increased the clocks. It's looking like the KS0 Ultras are using quite a bit of power. I also confirmed this with PB Farmer that some of these from straight out of the factory may be suffering from power. That's why we were seeing some units only hit 360 to 380 gig hash instead of the 400. So that's interesting on that aspect. Now, here we are currently at 511. Now, with the KS0 Pros and stuff, you know, you're only supposed to increase them like 2 millivolts, 4 millivolts, and so on. I'm already up 100 millivolts and I'm only at an 8% increase. So they are requiring more power. So we may even need larger power supplies, but I'm not at that point to determine it yet. We'll see where I can get this to based on my limited 180 watts. All right, guys, so I did a little bit of messing around here and I did hit upwards of 557 gigahash at the wall. We're using about 173 watts. So I couldn't go much more on this based on 180 watt power supply. So you are gonna need, it's looking like a lot more power. So there are reports of upwards of over 700 gigahash. That's around 230 watts or so is what they've been saying there. So you're gonna need something around 250 to 300 watts of a laptop power supply to power these. That's gonna get quite a bit more expensive. After you get fan shrouds and power supplies and everything, it's probably gonna be cheaper just to buy two KS0 Ultras. That way you have the 800 gigahash and you're only using 200 watts. You're still using less power than one of these overclocked for, you know, almost two KS0 Ultras. So, you know, throw it up in the air however you want, but I would recommend that over overclocking these. I did, as you can see, my voltages are all dropping now. I went back to stock settings. I do not plan on overclocking these. That does drop the efficiency quite a bit. And overall, I do plan on running efficiency, especially as the Caspa hash rate continues to climb. These are very great miners right now for the price and for the efficiency compared to all the other ones out there minus Bitmain, but then you're starting to take that away from it when you start doing that overclocking. So it's totally up to you. Obviously, a lot of people love OC and their equipment. If you only have a couple of them, then again, you don't really have to worry about the power as much. But here it is. This is what the numbers look like for me on the latest PB Farmer firmware. I can't wait for KS5L and KS5M firmware to release. That way we can start undervolting same clocks and possibly get more hash rate. But then again, that might not work out in our favor because these are requiring quite a bit more voltages than previous generations of these Caspa ASICs. Anyway, guys, thank you for checking this out. PB Farmer firmware OC overclocking stuff is finally here. Link down in the description. I will see you on the next one. Rabbit out.